Hey guys, this is Martha with Mishmash, and today I'm going to be doing a review of my September Ipsy bag. So this month's theme was street style. It came with a really cute bag in this silver with these nice studs on it, black zipper, really cute bag. So I got 5 items this month. This is my second Ipsy bag, and I'm really happy with it. So instead of doing a first impressions unboxing, I'm doing a review of all the products I got. So I've used these products multiple times in order to get a real feel for how I like them. And let's get started. So first we have this Be a Bombshell smooth criminal powder. This is a finishing powder that is pure silica, and overall it's not too bad. I've used it a couple times when I've had to work at the office all day, and I have noticed that I am less dewy when I use this compared to when I use my normal finishing powder, which is the Bare Minerals original translucent powder. This is supposed to be translucent also, but I've noticed that you have to use very little of it, otherwise it will make you turn white and a little bit ghostly. It also goes flying everywhere if you use too much, so it's a kind of a good indicator in a way. But overall, not too bad. If you have a problem with really oily skin, I would recommend this, because it'll help keep the shine down longer. But overall, not too bad of a product. This, from what I can tell, is a full-size product, and it's worth about $12. So that already pays for your Ipsy, because Ipsy only costs $10 a month. Alright, so next we have a nail polish by Pacifica. 7-free nail polish. It is 100% vegan and cruelty-free. It's in this nice deep red color. Great for fall. Its staying power is about average for what I've seen from nail polishes. I haven't used a lot of nail polishes, but overall, for me, it's not bad. I've had this on for about a week, and it has the normal chipping at the cuticle and at the tip. The middle is staying out pretty well. I did not use any base coat or any top coat when I did this, so I'm sure it will last a lot longer if I actually did the proper base and top coat. But overall, I really like the color. I didn't have a color this dark red in my collection, so I'm really looking forward to wearing this more and, you know, making it last longer with the proper prep and finishes. So, really like this. I also really like the detail on the cap. I thought it was really good, and the box it came in also had the same kind of detail. So I really like this, and this is a full size, and it's $9, and it's in the color red, red wine, you know, great fall color. So next I have a Herky lipstick in Cabernet. It looks really dark in the tube, but I'm actually wearing it today, and you can see it's not near as dark when you actually wear it. So I was really afraid of this because I don't wear a lot of dark lip colors, just because I work in an office setting and it's just not, you know, you don't want to look gothic when you work in the office. But like this color is okay. I've worn this 3 or 4 times now and I'm getting more used to it. It is a matte lipstick. It's my first matte. It is a little bit drying, so I have to either put a really good chapstick under it, usually like a Burt's Bees, or I put one of my Bare Minerals Moxie lip glosses over top, and that actually works out really well for me. And that's what I do with most of my lipsticks anyway. But I really like this. It's a great fall color for sure. This is a full size, and it's worth $13. Next we have a hand cream by Michael and Peach. It's English Growers. It's considered a luxury hand cream. It is 30 milliliters, and it is made in England. Overall, this isn't too bad of a hand cream. It takes a little bit longer for it to soak in. It takes about 5 minutes for my hands to stop feeling greasy after using it. But it's a really good moisturizer. The scent is, I'm not a big fan of scents, and it's got a little bit of a perfumey kind of scent to it. Overall, it's not too bad. I will use it, but it's not an everyday for me. It's more of a throw in your purse, and if your hands get dry, you can use it, but it's not my go-to hand cream just because of the smell. But the formula works out pretty well. So this, because it's made in England, it costs £17 for the full size, which is 60 milliliters, so twice as big as this. Using current pound to dollar conversions, this tube is worth about $13.50. So, great value. Good job, Ipsy, for that value of this month's bag. Last is this Nourish Organic Moisturizing Facial Cleanse. It's cucumber and watercress, but it's also fragrance-free. I have used this several times, and I actually really like it. This is, milliliters of this. Oh, this is 30 milliliters, so it's the same size as the hand cream, but the original of this for a full size is 6 ounces. This is 1 fluid ounce. So it's actually a really small sample. It's actually relatively kind of cheap stuff, because this bottle is worth about $2.30. But after using it several times, which I don't have a lot of facial cleansers to start with, and this is the first one I've ever used that's not an acne treatment facial cleanse. And I'm actually really happy with it. And it doesn't take a lot. I thought I was only going to get like 2 to 3 uses when I originally got this. But I've used it 4 times so far. And I could probably use this size for like a month before I run out. Because it only takes like a nickel size for me to wash my face with it. And it gets a little bit lathery. And it seems to work out pretty well. Especially for I use it at night. Or sometimes first thing in the morning if I don't feel like washing my face in the shower. But I actually really like this. I'm seriously considering purchasing this in the full size. So I might be doing that in a couple weeks, because I really actually like this as a facial cleanser. So that was it for my Ipsy review. Overall, I'm really pleased with what I got in Ipsy this month. This is only my second Ipsy, but so far they're doing really well. The value of this month's bag was $49.83, so just under $50, and you only pay $10, including shipping, for an Ipsy bag, and you get the makeup bag, and this month 5 items that were worth $50. So this month's value was really great. I will use everything in here, some of the stuff not as much as others, but I'm really pleased with the lipstick, the nail polish, and the face wash for sure. The lotion, I will use it eventually and, throw it in my purse and stuff. The finishing powder, it's on occasion when I don't want to get glossy as fast. But overall, really good products, really good bag this month, and I will leave the subscription link down below if you're interested in Ipsy, and give me a thumbs up, and subscribe if you're interested in more of these videos. So, thank you for watching.